came about of thinking of all our passions. Table, central to what we do for a living. So the idea to actually make a table as we go along with the wood or whatever else we may find, then use the table as a central piece around which all the other things might happen.
Start on a basket, because that's part of what we're trying to do on this trip.
It's to tell the story or the fable of our journey.
One that we hope to share.
Cheers. Cheers.
The higher I go, the cooler I become.
We wanted to hear what stories they have.
I got a story that I heard by my grandfather. There was a king who tasted a fruit from a tree called Amarula.
There was a race between a Kalulu, which is a rabbit, and a tortoise. The rabbit started running and the tortoise was coming. And then the rabbit ran.
We share as much as we humanly can and go into the small roads, into villages where, you know, people are not used to tourists. We stayed with a poor family in Mozambique and they brought us everything they could think of.
The little kids, they get fed the peanuts by just making them raw and making it into a paste.
In the countryside, there's still a tradition of hospitality. We've been welcomed so openly.
Ah, it's hot!
Repete!
It's so wonderful to be part of Africa and to be part of the African people.
Many of the things, you know, are disappearing so quick.
When we cut the big tree, we remove the inner things. The waves can never get inside here.
I can't think of once really that we've been treated as if we are women on our own.
What happens is when you're African and you travel like this, that you recognize pieces of yourself.
Africa does it for me. It stimulates all my senses.
Wherever we've been, we've just been received with a lot of joy and open arms.
Big smiles.
Big smiles. I mean, that says it all.
The heart of Africa. The heart of Africa. The heart of Africa.